The top of the tree's not working properly. Just, is it? What is it?
Ash. Looks like it.
Just if they haven't got any greens and that in there. And yellows.
Okay. We can't record it now.
Ye faithful, joyful and triumphant, oh come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels, oh come let us adore him, oh come let us adore him, oh come let us adore him, he implies the Lord. Sing choirs of angels, sing in exaltation, oh sing, oh me, citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the highest. Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come let us adore him. He is Christ the Lord. Lord, we breathe thee for this happy morning. Oh, Jesus, to thee be all glory given.
Good morning and welcome to our YouTube version of the Lifeboat Christmas Memorial Service. I'm sure that you're all aware at the moment that Wales is on a lockdown, so we were unable to hold our scheduled service at the boathouse today. So we've decided to do the next best thing, and I'm doing something from home which can be shared on YouTube to anybody who wants to be part of this today. Well, because this is a Christmas memorial service, it's only fitting that we consider the theme of Christmas. And because of Christmas Day being just a few days away, well, the most popular reading at this time of the year is from Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were angels, shepherds rather, living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Christ, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen. The familiar Christmas story. Mary, Joseph, and of course the baby Jesus. But you'll notice there was no mention of the man in the big red suit, Father Christmas, Santa Claus. Well, that's because St. Nicholas didn't come around until nearly three centuries later, born in AD 270 in Turkey with Greek ancestors. But Bethlehem was buzzing, not because of the baby Jesus, but because people gathered to be registered in a census. There were no computers or mailing systems in those days. Each man had to go physically to his ancestral town and register there. Now, even Joseph's relatives couldn't put him up for the night because they were already overrun with other family members. So that first Christmas was a crowded affair. No trimmings, no turkey, no as-the-price savings. And Jesus was born in the animal pen and laid in a feeding trough. Well, I guess Christmas is going to be a little different this year. Two households allowed to meet on Christmas Day. Social distancing, of course. Plenty of hand washing. Although for some people, the reason Christmas is going to be a little different is not because of the lockdown or because of the coronavirus. It's the fact that they've lost someone special this year. A husband, a wife, a father, a mother, a son or a daughter, even a child. And people have lost members of the family who were close to them. I've been privileged to be a part of the services to say farewell to many loved ones. And indeed, I've been privileged to be there for many of you who may be listening to this. Some of the names that I've seen on our virtual memory tree are names that are familiar to me. The names of people whose services I conducted. I know Christmas will be hard for many of you, for all sorts of reasons. But I also know that Christmas is more than just a festive season. Christmas is about hope and the promise of joy. Now, God didn't say that the joy would come with the baby born in Bethlehem. The angel said, "A Savior has been born, The baby lying in a manger was only the sign of the Saviour having come. That salvation didn't happen until 33 years later on a cross just outside Jerusalem. Joy will come to you again, but it may take a little time. There is light at the end of the tunnel. Christmas is a time for hope, and we all need a little bit of hope at this time. There are a lot of lonely people out there today, and there will be a lot of lonely people on Christmas Day. They're going to be even more lonely because of lockdown. And there are many people who are struggling with mental health issues that have been made worse this year because of lockdown. And again, this time will be exacerbated because of lockdown. Some of you won't see your family this Christmas. And some of you are probably complaining against the First Minister and all the other politicians that you won't be able to see your family. But you know, there are some people that I know, that I've met, who haven't seen their family in years, and certainly haven't seen their family since last Christmas. I want to encourage you today to take time to think about those who are lonely. Think about the homeless. Think about the bereaved. Think about the sick. And if you can, pick up the phone just to check on someone and talk to them. Somebody living on their own. Or maybe just let them talk to you. And if you can't pick up the phone and do it, then why not on Christmas Day knock on someone's door just to check how they are? Socially distanced, of course. You know, someone once said, not all heroes wear capes. Well, today we are holding a memorial Christmas service. And we're remembering people whose names have been included on the memory tree, the virtual memory tree, on our Facebook page. I've also been asked if we could remember some people that many people do think of, many people do remember, but perhaps not everybody, because it's somewhere that's not on our doorstep. We at the Lifeboat Station, we are there for anybody who needs us when they're in danger, either on the sea or around the coast. We are volunteers. All of our crew who go to sea are volunteers. They risk their lives for other people. They are, in my book, heroes. Well, there's one story, a true story, that touches our hearts at this time of the year. The Penley lifeboat went out on the 19th of December, 1981, and never came back. When you wake this morning, please take a few minutes to remember the 8 extremely brave, fearless and selfless lifeboatmen, all sons of Mousehole, who made the ultimate sacrifice on the 19th of December, 1981. Their courage, dedication, determination, valour and heroism served as a beacon to us all. Gone, but never forgotten. Greater love has no man. They were the words posted on the Facebook page in memory of the Penley lifeboat crew. And the names of those crew members who lost their lives are Nigel Brockman, William Trevelyan Richards, James Stephen Madron, Charles Thomas Greenough, John Robert Blewett, Kevin Smith, Barry Robertson Torrey and Gary Lee Wallace. And we remember those men and their families at this time. But we're also remembering people from our own communities, people whose names have been included on that memory tree. We haven't got time to read all of the names. These are a selection of the names. And if your name or your family that have placed a name on the tree isn't recognizing these names, please don't think we've forgotten you, because we have read every name and we remember every person. These are just some of the names. Elizabeth David, Ken Lawrence, Jack, Barbara Page, Trevor Page, Evan Williams, Neville Davis, Dorothy James, Dennis Parsons, Marjorie Parsons, Lynn Parsons, Peter Griffiths, Gwyn Griffiths, William Matthews, Michael Reddy, Glyndŵr and Edna Williams, Dale Thomas, Barbara Lewis, Ben Davis, Margaret Sloots, Hilda Sloots, and Henrik Schockenbrock, Sylvia White, and Gerald Davis. And we remember all these people, and we remember many, many more today. And we remember the families that are left behind, and those families that today are remembering their loved ones. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, at this Christmas time and always, we remember these people, their names and who they were. We also remember every name which has been added to our memory tree, and we thank you for their lives and the families and communities to which they belonged. Heavenly Father, we also pray for the loved ones of those we remember today. And we pray your love and peace, your comfort and grace be upon them. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, and the celebration of his birth. And we pray that the joy of the shepherd may be our joy today and over this Christmas period, and the hope of the world, Jesus, will bring hope into the new year and beyond. Lord God, we offer this and all our prayers in Jesus' name. Silent night, holy night, all is bright round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, shepherds quake at the sight. Glory stream from heaven afar, heavenly host sing alleluia. Christ the Savior is born, Christ the Savior is born. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light, radiant beam from thy holy face, with the dawn of redeeming grace. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Have a very merry and blessed Christmas, and please, please do stay safe and keep well. Bless you. Goodbye.